schooling play.
It's already filming, so.
We are doing five. Did I make the program or are there any left?
There's the podcast.
Okay, the best one. We are doing 5 10-minute. A little longer than skits, a little shorter than play, and somewhat longer than they're supposed to be. Depends on if we remember our lines or not to get the show finished, but.
And Shirley, you have plenty of fake blood for the dueling scenes. And not that black crap you got on eBay last time. All the wounded look like walking zombies.
Okay, check. Real looking fake blood. Anything else?
Yeah. Can you get Tylenol in bulk?
I don't know. Maybe at Costco?
All right, get a couple cases. Better yet, make it Vicodin.
Vicodin? Problem?
Yeah. You see, our illustrious producer has said he won't fund the play unless I cast his daughter in the lead role.
And I take it she's not an actor.
I don't even think she's human.
Come on, Frank. Can't be that bad.
Just wait. Just wait. All right. Let's not delay it any longer.
Okay. Actors on set, please.
Hi, Mr. Kelly.
Hi, Miss Evans. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. Daddy's supposed to say hello.
Duty? How's he doing? How's his bank account? His backache?
He's doing better.
Good. Let's keep him in good shape. We need him in good health. Romeo, where's our Romeo?
I haven't seen him.
Anybody seen Romeo? Great, just great. That's all I need. Dave.
Yeah, what?
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah, you.
What?
Can you help us out?
You want me to act?
Yeah, kinda, you know. Can you stand in for Romeo?
Sure, I'll try.
All right. You got a script for him? All I need you to do is read the proper dialogue at the right time.
Okay?
So you'll be acting.
All
right?
Me? Acting?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got any moves for us?
No. I'm a custodian. I don't have any moves.
All right. All you got to do is just stand there, and when I point to you, you read the dialogue in there, it's highlighted.
Okay.
All right. Are you going to be able to handle that?
I'll do my best.
All I need you to do is read the stupid line when I point to you. I'm sorry. I'm all wound up today. My apologies. Let's try to get through this as painfully as possible. From the balcony scene, please.
Mr. Kelly, I got a couple questions.
Oh, am I not surprised?
And what might those be, my dear?
Well, this Shakespeare guy, was he Russian or something? Because I don't know what language this is, but it sure ain't English.
It ain't? It isn't?
It can't be. Thee, thou, what's, who talks like that?
Well, my dear, that would be modern English. That's the way people used to talk a long time ago.
Oh, you mean like back in the 60s?
Yeah, exactly like the 60s. Who could forget the timeless classic hit by the Beatles? I want to hold thy hand. Let's just continue.
Romeo? Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? What is she asking that of you?
Excuse me?
I mean, he's standing right there. But does she need glasses or something?
My father, art in heaven.
easy. Remember the funding.
Funding. Yeah, yes, funding, Chris. Thank you. It's good to keep things in perspective. My dear Miss Evans. She's not asking where he is, but why he is.
Oh, no.
Why is he a Montague? Their families are feuding. They don't get along. Juliet is lamenting the fact that Romeo can't be somebody different. Be free to love him.
Oh, so it's like philosophical. I took philosophy back in college. I didn't really get it. So I changed it, I dropped it, and I did interpretive dance.
Frank.
I'm out of it. Sorry. I just saw my life flash before my eyes, and it wasn't pretty.
You know what would be really funny, Mr. Kelly? What if we did this whole play in modern language? OMG, Romeo, you are my BFF. LOL.
Forget the fake blood. Give me a razor. You can have every ounce of mine.
Take it easy. Maybe you could talk to her dad and just some reason. Does he know how bad she is?
Nobody knows how bad she is. Nobody. 2 weeks. In 2 weeks, this play opens, and my career will be as dead as Shakespeare.
Come on, Frank, you've worked with Worth. I've heard once heard you say you could train a monkey to play Hamlet.
With a monkey, I have more to work with. You're right, you're absolutely right. I'm Frank Kelly, director to the stars. Henry Higgins had Liza, I've got Juliet.
That's the spirit.
I'll tell you what. On the safe side, have the razor ready. All right? Miss Evans, you bring up a fabulous point. You have to understand the works of Shakespeare are timeless and classic. The language is what gives it its beauty and elegance. And I truly believe that we can get through this. So once again, let me hear Juliet.
Whatever.
Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or, if thou wilt not, be but sworn by love, and thou no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak of this?
'Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not Montague. What is a Montague? It is not hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Oh, be some other name. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name, and for that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
By George, she's got it.
That was absolutely beautiful.
Well, thanks. But to be honest, I didn't understand half of it.
Nobody does, but they paid through the nose to see it. And Dave, you did remarkably well.
Oh, thank you.
In fact, I'm starting to feel a lot better about this whole play thing. And my dear Miss Evans, in 2 weeks, you will grace the stage as one of the greatest Juliets ever.
Well, thanks. But about that, Mr. Kelly, I have some friends that are going to Cancun. So I was thinking, if you didn't mind, that maybe I would go with them. Mr. Kelly?
Yeah, get yours and see.
loves me. Have you smelled his shirts?
What?
You take his laundry and you stick your face right in there. Take a big old whiff. And if there's some kind of perfume in there, you're gonna smell it.
Yeah, I'm not smelling my husband's laundry. I'm not doing that.
Listen, you need to take good advice from honest salespeople and bathroom scales.
How would this scale even know that my husband was cheating on me?
Energy fields.
What?
Electronic devices are very sensitive to all the tension in the air, and it...
Ridiculous.
And yet, there it is.
Do you smell your boyfriend's clothes?
Well, I'm not currently married, but I have been known to smell my boyfriend's laundry from time to time, and it's pretty clean, except for some man sweat, and my man sweat smells pretty awesome.
Step on the scale.
What?
Come on, step on it. I want to see what it says for you.
No.
Are you afraid?
No.
Well, let's go then.
Fine. Oh, that can't be right.
Your boyfriend's cheating on you.
That's completely inaccurate.
Exactly.
That's not even anywhere close.
That's what I said. Now, give me my money back.
Unless it is.
What?
Barry has been working late a lot lately.
Well, people do work late.
And he hasn't been as affectionate as usual.
Yeah, stop. That's ridiculous. The scale is lying.
That rat bastard!
Oh, don't be silly. He loves you.
Does he?
Well, how could he not?
You don't know.
The scale doesn't know.
I think the scale knows.
No, that's ridiculous. Your boyfriend's not cheating on you. My husband's not cheating on you. The scale's a liar. Let's try something.
Okay.
Prentice, they were to 50-50 and come to that bastard. I confronted him. you see?
A bunch of stuff.
Yes, a bunch of stuff. But the bunch has gotten smaller.
Really?
Now, what do you make of that?
Thanks.
I say the singular rather than the plural.
What makes you think that?
Cruel instinct.
Wow, you went on CSI. Maybe you can go work for the police department.
Oh, well, if I was working for the police department, I'd put out an all-points bulletin for a little girl who lives in a neighborhood she's last seen wearing a brown t-shirt and pink sparkle clogs.
How can you be so sure it's me, Mom?
It's easy. The only things missing from the bunch are yours. Smiling things are still part of the bunch.
But
what?
We're selling all my good stuff.
Sam, we talked about this. The place we're moving to doesn't have near the space that we have here. We have to downsize, get rid of some things.
But
what? We talked about this, remember? We agreed. Well, tell me how you remember our agreement.
We would both get rid of a few things because when we move to a new apartment and it's in a beautiful town with a really, 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 really nice playground.
But what?
But it's small.
Sacrifices, Sam. Sometimes in life, you need to make sacrifices.
I know, but couldn't you sacrifice more of your stuff so I could be fine? I know, I'm being selfish. Put it all back.
You'll see, the clothes we're selling we haven't worn in years. And the other things, well, we still have two or three of. We'll never miss any of these things. You'll see. not, don't stay very long.
So, I'm Mrs. William.
Well, I just decided that it's not prudent to form any attachments because people don't stay long. But when Georgia came home and told me about your son, I had to come and introduce myself and give you my sincere condolences.
My son? But I don't have a son.
No, not anymore. But because of the fever and the curse and the fever and the rollerblade, because of the rollerblading accident, he lost his leg. And then because of the fever, he lost his leg. It must have been very hard on you.
The rollerblading accident?
Yes. Did they ever find the taxi driver that hit him?
The driver?
Well, I don't really think it matters because it was the curse and the fever that finally took the blow.
Oh, the curse?
Yes, the voodoo curse that the woman put on the rollerblades. Your daughter told Georgie all about it. Yes. Now, the only suggestion I would have is that you burn the veil, because it probably still has contacts. Now, I really must go.
Burn the veil?
That would be my suggestion, but I really must go. But I do have to tell you that if my Georgie gets typhoid fever from touching that bear, I will sue you.
Samantha!
Thank you. technical about it. I had a cell phone. The brand new.
You
I know is that we discussed it about two committees ago. It was made up of a completely different member. We actually had those committees who chaired this one and that one who chaired this committee anyway. Who chaired this committee? Anyway. Anybody?
I don't think we haven't voted for one. We should.
Well, we could test each other and then get together and decide what our committees would be doing.
Oh. Okay. Yeah. I can hear. All right, so let's vote. Someone nominate me. Shall I? And well, wait a minute. If someone's going to nominate me, I need somebody to chair the committee.
You?
What's their name again?
We don't have a name. We never gave it a name. We could.
Questionable. However, I, for one, did not know that
makes his list so popular. Now, I know we haven't had the most successful process. That happens when no one shows up for an interview. But do not lose hope, Spock. We will find an appropriate drill magnet soon enough.
My card broke down. Why did you put the thought? okay with it? Are you really buying this?
What do you mean?
This guy is insane. He thinks he's the man of the Starship Enterprise. He's not running a legitimate business here. Why did he raise this up like this? Thank you.